I forgot to switch off the fan. How are you guys? I hope everyone is doing great. I hope you guys are staying safe. Today's video is one of my most frequently asked questions, like overall. I don't exactly know how to explain today's video, but it is going to be a lot of tips and tricks and sort of like a guidebook plus my own journey as an Indian model. So let me just start off by telling you guys a little more about my own journey. I started when I was in my second year of college. I did the most basic bitch thing. I worked with a lot of local photographers, people that were looking to build their profile. I just did a lot of shoots with them. I got to know some great people, and that is my tip to you guys. Always start off with local photographers instead of getting like a professional portfolio done, which is another thing that I did. My mom and dad knew that I wanted to get into modeling, so unhone ek professional photographer dhunda, and we got my first ever portfolio shoot done from this photographer, which was actually a very good experience since I had never been on set before. That was nice for an experience, but it was very costly and it did not actually teach me anything at all about modeling. Here's my tip to you guys: do not spend money straight away. Start by learning and exploring things about yourself, because there are a lot of photographers, agencies, camps that promise you a lot of things. They are just gonna take your money and we of course do not want that. And if you do not have photographer friends or people with a camera, you can still work on yourself using your own phone, your front mirror, the mirror in your bedroom. Anything works. Just start working on yourself before seriously investing into it. So me and my college best friend Aisha, we both knew that we wanted to be models, right? And we did a lot of shoots for free, a lot, when we were getting started. Since I am almost a year older than Aisha, I started working before her, so I think I did 3 shoots for almost 1.5 years. And I was working almost every single day. I don't think it was a waste of time or energy or anything of that sort, because I got to learn so much that was actually very valuable to me in the later half of my modeling career. So do not look for money right from the start. It is always good to work on yourself and learn new things while you're growing, so you know when you are better at your craft that you can charge more. I hope that makes sense. And then college ended and me and Aisha, we had the decision to choose between freelancing and joining an agency, both of which are equally relevant and equally respected in the industry. But it was just up to our personal preferences that Aisha decided to join an agency and I wanted to do freelance work. The only reason that I chose to be a freelancer is that I wanted to work on my own schedule. I could not get used to the idea of someone else telling me what to do, where and when. I like managing my own things that I always have, and I just want to have that freedom to be able to choose my own work, which is why I chose freelancing, which honestly worked out great for me. So if you guys are confused on how to start, where do we start? First off, get used to being in front of a camera. Get comfortable with yourself, know your good angles, practice your poses, and when you have gotten everything down and you're confident in yourself and you're sure that you want to become a model, then you just need to choose between freelancing or joining an agency. If you join an agency, then you have to click your Polaroids and send it to some agencies. I will list some of the top Indian modeling agencies in my description, so you guys can check them out. And of course, if you want to be a freelancer, things are going to be a little harder than being in an agency, because when you're in an agency, they handle everything for you. They find work for you, they talk to the clients, they negotiate and basically everything. So you just have to show up at the shoot and be done with the day. But when you're a freelancer, you're going to be your own manager, you're going to be your own stylist sometimes, your hairstylist, your driver. You're gonna have to do everything on your own. So if you are ready for that life, I personally think freelancing is amazing. After almost 7 to 8 years of modeling, I gradually realized that it is not something that I enjoy a lot anymore. I actually fell in love with content creation and designing, so which is essentially why modeling took a little step back. But I do have some skills that I learned over the years and I would love to share them with you guys. especially since I am not in the competition anymore. First off is your basic photography skills. You need to know your good angles, the good lighting, and just have like a overall good presence in front of a camera. The second skill that you guys need to learn is time management and organization. This is especially for people that are going to opt for freelancing as a career. Now, there are a lot of people that work multiple jobs alongside modeling, like I did. You are probably going to book a lot of different jobs on the same day. So time management is the most important thing for you. You have to know how to manage your time and be there on time. I know it's very, very hard. I would know. It's just a very, very important skill to learn. And if you just do not have the knack for it, use some apps, write it down in your notes, do anything but be on time, because that is going to make you look very professional. The next skill that you guys absolutely need is communication and being a good listener. Accept feedback from the photographer and the client. This is slightly complicated because there are going to be a lot of times when you do not agree with the client or the photographer at all. But the most sensible thing to do in that situation is to just accept the feedback and try to work according to the client, because at the end of the day, you are working for the client. I absolutely do not mean to let any other person disrespect you and you just have to sit down and take it. I do not mean that, but you just have to be very, very professional and non-emotional on set, because that is going to make a client want to work with you again and again, which is what you want ultimately. So be a good listener, do not argue back, and accept feedback and work on yourself. The next skill that I am still struggling to learn is drawing boundaries and saying no. I personally have a very, very hard time saying no to anything and anyone, because I don't have a reason for it. But in this line of career, it is so important to know your boundaries and be vocal about it. You have to be able to say that there are some things that you're okay with doing and some things that you might not be okay with doing. I learned it a lot later in my career that it is okay to say no, because initially I did not think I had the authority or the power to say no on a set, because honestly it is a little intimidating at times. Know that you have to respect yourself first. So you do what is good for you and what feels right to you. If that means stepping back, step back. Now this next tip is especially if you guys are a freelancer, or if you guys are wanting to be a freelancer, you need to brand yourself. There are a lot of people looking for the same job that you are. So you need to brand yourself in the way that you stand out. And the most important tip that you will need while you're branding yourself is not trying to be like someone else, because that someone else is already there living their lives in the same industry. So no one would want like a second copy of that person. Even if it is a celebrity, I think it is very, very important to stick to your own individual style and work on bettering yourself rather than blatantly copying someone else, because you are you and you are the only you. So that is your biggest USP and you guys need to use that. The next tip is again for my freelancers. If you guys are in an agency, then your managers and the agency will do the negotiating part. But if you guys are freelancing, you need to know your worth and negotiate. It is going to be super awkward, very hard to do, but it is honestly one of the most important things about the job. You need to make sure that you are getting paid according to your worth and the quality of your work. Honestly, being underpaid is a very normal thing in this industry, but it is going to take away a lot of happiness from this job. So make sure that you are getting paid well. Also, do your research if you're just getting started. Ask a couple of other models that have worked for the same brand before, or someone that works in the same category. That's always a good tip. The last and the most important skill is networking and self-control. Modeling is a job where networking and marketing yourself is honestly so important, especially if you want to book newer jobs and newer clients. But at the same time, self-control is equally important, because it is a job where literally anything that you do is going to show up on your face. So if you're into alcohol, drugs, smoking, anything like that, it is going to show up on your face eventually. So make sure that you do not get too carried away by the entire glamour and the jhagmag of this industry. My personal tip is to treat your job like a job and then relax and party whenever the job is done. That way you can easily distinguish between your personal life and your professional life. I think there is space for everyone in the industry. If you think you don't fit into the conventional model stereotype, just know that a brand is out there looking for someone exactly like you. You just need to be patient and keep working on being the best version of yourself. Modeling is actually a pretty tough job if you ask me. It requires a lot of skill, a lot of patience, a very thick skin and strong legs, because they are going to keep you standing for hours at a stretch. If you ask me, it is definitely worth it. It has given me honestly such great times, and I owe almost all of my confidence to modeling. I would never actually hate it, but there are a lot of things that I wish I could change about the industry, but that is a topic for another time. These were my personal tips to anyone that is just starting out. I hope this was useful. If you guys found this useful, make sure you like, share, subscribe, do your thing. Especially share this with people that you think would find this useful. And I absolutely love you guys for your amazing response on my last video. I see you guys, I appreciate you, and I absolutely love you back, and I'll see you guys the next time.